from News 8 WMTW-TV. This is a News 8 Now update.
Good morning. Welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sample. The Farmington Police Chief says authorities have collected voluntary DNA samples from more than 70 men looking for a match to evidence found at the scene of a homicide. 2 weeks ago, 81-year-old Grace Burton was stabbed to death during a home invasion at her Farmington apartment. According to the police chief, dozens of men who have criminal histories live in the area or who have come under suspicion and have been asked to give DNA samples. Only one man has refused. The chief and state police declined to comment on camera about the tactics, but some civil liberties groups and defense attorneys say it is unconventional and problematic.
That they've said it needs to be probable cause to have a search of this magnitude. So the police need to have a very good reason for thinking that somebody is connected to a crime. And if they have that, they should go to a judge and get a warrant.
While there are also concerns that those giving up their DNA might not know that they can actually refuse or speak with an attorney first, and some question where the DNA information will go. Well, it survived Russia's nuclear bomb scare, but it will not survive Augusta's new $17 million sewer pipeline project. Standing directly in the way of the new line is this Cold War era bomb shelter, which Donald Tuttle built in his backyard during the 1950s. Now, while Tuttle no longer owns the property, he says he was disappointed to learn that the utility crews would have to remove the shelter, which he calls an historic icon to the Cold War. Of course, while there was never a serious bomb threat, Tuttle says the shelter still got plenty of good use.
Well, whenever my mother-in-law came, and I used to get down there on, we had bad thunder showers. My wife and I used to get on. You can't even hear them down there. It's cool. And I used to keep vegetables down there, a nice cool place.
Well, according to the Augusta Utility District, it attempted to design the pipeline to go around the shelter, but ultimately it could not. Well, NASA weather officer says there is a 60% chance that wet weather could delay Friday's planned liftoff of the shuttle Atlantis. The launch is scheduled for 11:26 a.m. Countdown clocks for the historic launch started ticking this afternoon, and this last shuttle mission will be a supply run to the International Space Station. As many as 1 million spectators are expected to jam the Cape Canaveral area in Florida for the historic send-off. And while it'll be a trip of a lifetime for a Sacco man, Brent Danley is headed to the Kennedy Space Center to tweet on the final launch of NASA's space shuttle program. NASA is bringing together 150 Twitter followers for what is being called a two-day tweet-up. Brent Danley says he's very excited that he'll be a part of history, and he's fascinated by science and the space program. He insists that this is not a two-day vacation. However, this is something he's very passionate about and is taking very seriously.
NASA's bringing me down there so that I can share my enthusiasm and with the people here in Maine and share with them the things that I'm learning, doing, pictures, tweets. So, yeah, I feel a huge sense of responsibility.
Danley will leave at 3 a.m., and you can follow him on Twitter at Brent Danley and his Twitter name for those of you with the accounts. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sibb. We'll be right back.